Guys, welcome once again for the WeMaker webinar. This is a product webinar. It's a closed webinar to the community alone. And you know, if you have any questions regarding the product or something, this is probably the best time to drop it. And we can communicate one-on-one as well to address the same. The objective of the webinar is to quickly run you guys through the properties of WeMaker, the different features we have around WeMaker. Like the problem we have is many of them have signed up, but they are not aware of the complete potential of this particular tool. And which is why we want to do these webinars to help them understand what exactly is this tool capable of so that you can use this tool to the optimum potential. And at the end, if you guys have any suggestions for improvement or if you guys have any feedback with respect to the features, we are always open to it and we'll definitely look into it. I think you would have heard from Josh, we are pretty high, pretty good with the customer support so far. So we just want to continue with the same there as well. So on that note, if you guys haven't done this already by now, you should be doing it. If you guys have just signed up, please go to WeMaker.com. You can click the sign up or the login now button in order to get started with it. And if you are using a Mac, you always have the option to download the Mac. Once you log in, this is a dashboard you will be into. And you always have the option to download WeMaker either as the Mac application if you're using a Mac, or if you're using Windows, then you always have the option to add the Chrome extension, as you can see here on top. So these are the two tools which are currently live. Meanwhile, we are working on the Windows application and in future also through the mobile applications as well. So those are due for release later this year. But as of now, if you're a Windows user, please use the Chrome. If you're a Mac user, please download the Mac. And let me just quickly run you through. Firstly, if I think many of you here would have been a free user, if that is the case, you do have a 15 GB storage limit in the free plan. And once you upgrade to any of those paid plan, you get an unlimited storage count there as well. So this dashboard, what you see is completely cloud-based. It is web-based, whatever you're recording, edits, everything is being saved on cloud. And you have unlimited storage for this. So that is the first valid point. And not many tools have offered this so far, but then, we just want to get started with probably a big bang, for all the users. So yes, you do get unlimited storage with all the pay plans. And that is the first thing I want to share. Now, secondly, once you have downloaded the app or the Chrome extension, let me just take you through the Chrome extension. I believe you can't see it now. So let me just share my entire desktop probably. Can you guys see my desktop completely now?
Oh yeah, your screen is fully visible. Yes.
Okay, so all right, cool. So let me just launch the app firstly. So once you have downloaded, once you install, it's a pretty straightforward install. You can just go ahead and open the application. And there are a few features here again, which are limited completely to the paid plan there. And let me just walk you through quickly what exactly it is. I know many of you would know this, but then, for people who have just joined, or people who have been starting it new, I'm pretty sure this would be useful. So, you can see that once you have opened the app, just gets in and just log in. And once you click on the three buttons here, you can see, the different workspaces you are a part of. So make sure if you are in a paid plan, this is a confusion which many people ask us. They say that, I've signed in, but I'm still in the light plan. So if you just click on this, you will see the list of workspaces you have and make sure you chose the right one. The plan will always be upgraded, notified there. And make sure if you are from a free plan, if you use a different mail ID and move to a paid plan, then make sure you choose the right one and you choose the right login there as well. So that's the first one. And secondly, there is this preference option, which many people haven't discovered yet. But then this is exactly where you can completely control the application. You can customize the features basically for your own need and you can take it from there. So whether it is using system audio or if you need a recording countdown or not, and highlighting mouse clicks or annotations, showing the control menu, basically the one which appears on the left while you are recording. Some people don't like it. They prefer using the hotkeys for that. All those things you can control from there. And we do advise you to enable the auto update. As you guys know, we are in a verge of releasing almost an update every 2 weeks. And we would really suggest you to turn the auto update on so that you don't miss out on any features. And if your preference menu is not looking like this, you probably haven't updated the app in a long time. So I would suggest you to go ahead and update the same as well. And then there is shortcuts quickly for you to customize your shortcuts or keyboard hotkeys as well. And once again, the initial shortcuts, many people felt that it is interfering with their, current, keyboard shortcuts. So if you are facing a similar issue, you can just use this to, change the same as well. Let me just go back. This is first thing with this. And then, yes, obviously you see the regular ones. You get the option to record your screen, webcam, screen plus webcam, and then schedule. So the screen plus webcam also comes in with another interesting feature. And this is probably one of my favorite features in vMaker as well. It's called frames. You can see my face once again here. And you can see that there is a popper icon here. If you just click on it, you can see that you can add frames, you know, to your video as well. So right now you see a plain background, a plain white circle, and I can simply choose this particular frame shape. And maybe, you know, if I need to, you know, make something funny, or if I'm sending a birthday wish for one of my customer, or let's say it's a Friday evening, but then, you know, I need to send something quirky, or if I'm sending a video to a prospect and I want him to remember my name, then yes, I can choose all those things. And you also get the option to choose your color, you know, to make sure it is matching your particular brand. And then, you know, you can change the font here as well. And you can change the text here as well. So yep, once you're done, just click done. And you can see that on the left, you know, this is being updated. It says vMaker. Now, many people are innovative and they use this to update it as a CTA as well, like callers, or update their phone number, or things like that. People can get creative. If you have some ideas like that, please do share us, or please do share with the community. They'll be excited to learn from your particular use case as well. We also have the custom background option, which is a work in progress. And we'll be launching that soon as well. And there is the sell out option, which, you know, wherein you can crop out your backgrounds and unwanted virtuals, etc. So you are seeing some backgrounds in my space as well. So I can just crop out and make it, make sure it looks more professional. So that is also something, a work in progress. And make sure you have it on auto update so that you can see this when it is launched. The next thing, it is an important thing, and it is called schedule option. So basically, let's say, you know, you are attending this webinar, but then at the end, you know, you say that, oh my God, you know, I just missed recording this particular webinar. So in order to avoid issues like that, if you have a call, if you have an important client call scheduled, then all you can do is just click on the scheduler option and enter the particular title. For example, I'm creating a lot of typos today. Just enter your title and then choose the date and the time. The only restriction here is that the time should be at least 15 minutes before the start of the webinar. You need to schedule this. So I'm just going to randomly put it as 11 p.m. to probably 11:30. And then I have the option to get a confirmation before, you know, the recording kicks in. So if at all, you know, I don't need it, then no problem. Or, you know, I can just leave it and it automatically starts recording when the call starts and when I join in. So for these to work, please keep your application open. This cannot manually override your system permissions. So you have to keep the application open. And once you join the call, it just automatically records your particular screen so that you don't have to miss out on any of the important recordings in the future as well. So once I click on schedule recording, yep, it says, you know, a pop-up stating that, you know, it is done. And to confirm this, you can see that there is a small red color light, which has been there popping up over the schedule option. So that just confirms us that, you know, there is a scheduler in place and, you know, there is a scheduling which you have already scheduled for later. The next option is, yes, these are pretty regular ones. You have the option to record full screen, or you can record a particular window, or you can just draw a custom size within your window as well and then record only that particular part. And this is another best part. So right now it is the default face HD camera from the MacBook. You can just click on the dropdown. And if you're using an external camera, you have the option to switch. Now, for this particular video, I don't have an external camera, but I do have an external mic. So you can see that, you know, it automatically detects whatever external device, and I can just click on that external particular microphone and it automatically takes it. And the best part, once you join in by default, there is a chance this particular resolution is not set, you know, to HD. It might be in auto. So again, you know, many people have stated that there has been issues with the same. So if you guys are facing any issues on quality, you can just switch to a higher resolution. Now, if you are in the free plan, you will get only up to 480 pixels. But then, you know, once you upgrade to any paid plan, you will get up to 4K resolution. So that is the best part. Now, yep. So this is pretty much about the tool at this point of time. And you can see that the control menu, oh, there is one more thing, which is called annotations. If I just click on the draw icon from here, yep, I can choose one particular color. Let's say we choose yellow. And then, you know, I can just go ahead and draw it on the screen. And, you know, if I need to highlight any particular thing there as well, I need to start recording in order to use this. So which is why I couldn't use it. But then, okay, let me just start recording just to show you guys how it works. So yeah, this is the countdown which many people don't want, and I can disable this. Now it is recording, and you will get a sound, by the way, once it starts recording. So yep, I have chosen the annotate option, and you can see that, you know, I can annotate, and there is also a mouse emphasis, which basically means wherever I click, you can see that there is a small highlight now which pops up whenever I click as well. Now, yep. So that is pretty much there with the application. Once I stop recording, you can see that it is getting automatically updated. Let me just close that for now. And let me just stop sharing my screen and then start again so that we can move on to the first surprise, which we want to inform all of you guys today. Javan, can you please help me once the screen share has dropped? I'm not sure if there is a small delay.
I do see your screen being shared, Lakshman. It's not yet stopped.
All right. Let me just think. I still have to pause this. Yep. Yep. Yeah. Is it paused now?
Yeah, it's gone.
All right, cool. So that brings us to our first, announcement for the day, which we need to make. And yes, I think I need to share my screen again. Just give me a sec. Can you see it now?
Yes.
Yes. So most of you might know this, that, this is the regular pricing for, vMaker. If you guys, there are basically two plans, and then there is the enterprise plan. If you are a startup founder, or if you are a medium-sized business, we always recommend the teams plan to start with. If you are a solopreneur, then yes, you can always get started with the startup plan. Now, if you go for monthly, this exactly is the pricing, and yearly you get a default discount from the website. Now, the best part is that we have a lifetime deal, which is on with AppSumo currently, which basically means you can get the Teams plan, which is for $10 per month per user, and you can get that almost at 95% off for a lifetime deal. And the basic plan comes out at $49 for 3 users, and it is a lifetime deal. So even if you calculate for a year, for 3 users, it'll be somewhere around $360, but for lifetime, you can avail it for $49. And that is the first announcement. If you guys haven't known this already, then yes, you can go ahead and check it out. We only have 3 days remaining. The deal is just going off by this 22nd. So if you guys haven't tested out the tool, please go ahead, check out the tool with the free plan, and whatever paid plan you feel, they all come with the Teams plan. And the best part here is that, which takes me to my second one. This is our public roadmap. Some of these features which are listed here are currently in our pipeline, and we are working on the same. And once these features are live for the Teams plan, you also get them with this particular deal. It doesn't mean that you need to pay extra for whatever future releases we account for. Any future releases that accounts for the Teams plan, you would be getting the same along with this deal. So anything like custom background or screen blur and all these options, whatever you see listed here under the Teams plan, you will be getting all those, plus the Windows application when it is launched, or the mobile applications when it is launched. So all those things with the features, you can avail for the same thing. And there are different tiers in AppSumo as well. I think, Javan, can you please help me share the link?
Yes, we already shared it in the chat.
Oh, okay. That's great. So I think you would have got the link in the chat. So that is the first announcement for today. So if you guys haven't tried it already, please go ahead and check it out. And if you guys are in the free plan, I cannot think of a better deal. I don't think they'll have a better deal than this or anywhere close to this in the near future to come. So if you guys haven't availed it already, please go ahead and check it out. And if you guys have any questions with the upgrade or with the activation, please reach out to us. So that takes us to the first part. Let me just quickly take you to the next part of the video, which is basically explaining the dashboard functionality. So whatever video you just record, it just saves in your dashboard automatically. This is the place where you can see all your videos. You have a few options here as well. So the first one is dashboard, wherein you can see your video. And here is when, if you just hover over any video, you can see the multiple options here. So the vMaker does come in with an editor as well, a default inbuilt editor wherein you can trim your video, probably remove the audio, etc. So those sort of things are available within this. And then you have the option to play, duplicate, or you can move, which basically means you need to create a folder. You can see that I've already created a few folders here. Just click on this icon. And with that, you can just create a folder. So once you have created this folder, you also have the option to share this particular folder with your teammates as well. Now, basically me and Josh, when we work, if there is a review to happen, we just quickly record it, we make a recording and put it on the folder, and there's just inform anyone so that they can just go ahead and check it out. So it just helps with collaborating as being more collaborative as a team. That is the first one. And secondly, there is a My Team option, which basically means if you guys have more than one member in your team, or let's say you purchase the AppSumo plan and if you want to add more people into your team, this is exactly where you do it. Wherein you just go ahead, enter that particular teammate's mail address, and you have the option to add them as a member as well as adding them as an admin as well. So if you just don't want them to have any other option, for example, if you just want them to create video and then just use it, then please choose the admin option. Please choose the member option. If you want them to give the access to add new members, then please choose the admin option. This is basically the shared with me folder. It just works like Google Drive. If somebody has shared a video or a folder with you, this is exactly where you go ahead and check those items. You can see that there are a few here. And finally, the most interesting thing, which is called branding. So this has been a recent addition to us, and we are very happy that it is live as well. Now, when you share your video, this is exactly how the player page looks. This is how the player page looks. You can see that if you are in the free plan, you would be bombarded with WeMaker branding at this point of time. You can see that the WeMaker logo is here. There is a share button, and there is a banner here, etc. Now, once you upgrade to a pay plan, you would not see all these things. You would get a pretty much plain, player page devoid of WeMaker branding. So that is what you get. Plus, you also have the option to customize the brands here as well, wherein you can see that you can just turn off, the WeMaker branding, you can add your own brand logo there. Plus, you can add your fave icon, which appears on top there. And finally, you can also revise the player page color to suit your own particular brand. So if you have a particular color, you can just click on this, update the brand color, and then, see it. And finally, you can also enable a CTA. Right now, if you see with the player page, it says, share. And this video is playing. All right. So you see the share button over here on top right corner, and you can just customize this as well to match your own particular, CTA. So if, let's say, you're sending a sales pitch, and if you want them to sign up, or if you want them to reach out to you or something, anything of those sorts, you can just customize the CTA and add the link there as well. So let me just show you. You just say enable CTA, and it asks for CTA text and the CTA URL. Just update these two, click save, and it'll all be there. That is how it works. So custom branding is another great feature, especially if you're looking at WeMaker, wherein you share these videos with some of your clients or external workers. Then yes, I definitely recommend upgrading so that you can get this particular feature, wherein you can completely customize the player page to suit your own brand. It looks like an in-house tool there as well. One more thing with the player page, what you're missing out right now is this option called timer. So if at all I'm sharing this particular video and I just don't want to give you the access forever, then in that case I can just set a timer for this video, which basically means, let's say, I just want this to be available for the next 5 days, or next 3 days, whatever. You can just send it, and after that the link would not work. If they try to access the video post this particular timing period, then yes, the link will not work. So if you guys are sharing some confidential information or anything you don't want the client to have it past a particular date, then yes, you can avail this particular feature as well, in order to take complete control of your video. So yep, that's the quick roundup with the tool, with the application, and with the dashboard functionalities we have here. And once you see, if you're a Windows user, yes, of course, we don't want to lose you out, because I myself is a powerful Windows user. So we have the Chrome extension for you guys. The Chrome extension comes in with pretty much all the functions we have discussed so far, except a few functions which miss out, as like, schedule the recording feature. But other than that, you have the basics: screen, webcam, and screen plus webcam option. You have the full screen recording, you have the current tab recording. Yes, you do have the option to choose external microphones, etc. as well. And again, you have the preferences menu here as well, with which you can control a few things, like including tab audio, including countdown, all those things, whatever you saw on the app. Most of these features are available here as well. Now, if you guys are a Windows user, and if you upload to the paid program by this, and probably you have the best offer in front of you, if you guys choose to upload it, upgrade to that particular thing, then yes, you would get the access to Windows application as well. When it is launched, whatever deal you are in, you can use the Windows application. You just saw the Mac application. It'll probably have the same features, if not more features than what you see in the Mac. And once that is live, you will get access to the same as well. So that is the deal which we want to present to you. And since it is only 3 days remaining, we don't want to miss you out. We don't want you to miss it out. Probably, you know, instead of paying $300, you can just get it for $50. So that is the deal which is currently there. And I believe Jervin has shared the link already. So please do avail it. It's only 3 days, and you know, you won't see this after you know, the deal is over. Which takes me to the last part and the most excited announcement I need to make. For the first time, I think you would be the guy seeing it as well. We have introduced a new program which is called VMaker of the Week. You know, basically it should be VMaker of the Month, but then, you know, for we are calling it VMaker of the Week. Every month we would be picking one member from the community, and you know, this is based on their usage of VMaker, you being a power user of VMaker, getting some brilliant results with the tool, and then, you know, sharing us some amazing feedback. So based on all these criteria, we choose VMaker of the Week every month. And this week, we are happy to introduce you to Belinda, who's our community member. Unfortunately, I wanted her to have, you know, have her on the call as well, but there was some timing constraints, so I couldn't bring her in. I'm sure she has recorded a video, and we'll make sure it is available on our YouTube channel as well. So yes, big shout out to Belinda from belindaevan.com. You can just see her website. She's a digital marketing specialist, and she specializes on Google Ads, and you can feel free to go ahead to our website, book a 30-minute strategy call as well. So yeah, that's a shout out from our end for one of our own internal user. And yeah, hopefully we see one from, you know, for the next month, we see somebody who is there in the attendee list to be here as well. So yep, this is a small cheer from our end to one of our user who has contributed so much to, you know, our application at this point of time. So yes, with that, I just want to round this up and, you know, leave you guys with a final note wherein, you know, you have the option to upgrade if you are a free user to the paid plan, and you can do it almost at 95% off. Other than that, if you guys have any questions regarding the upgrade, regarding the feature, or if you guys are facing any difficulty or any doubts with the application so far, we are open to answer it right now. So I'm just waiting. Let me just stop sharing my screen. Yep, so that we can have a proper chat. If you guys have any questions, you know, this is the time, and you can drop it in the chat column or you can drop it in the Q&A column. Me and Jervin are here to help you answer the same live. Yep, so I'll just wait for the questions for a couple of minutes. If you don't get any, then yes, we can always catch up in the live chat and we can take it from there. Well, if you don't have any questions, please feel free to just drop in and say hi as well. We just got a few shout outs from Maria, Harshita, and all those people. Yes, once again, a big hi to you people as well. Thanks for joining in. And finally, I hope all of you guys are staying safe there as well. That is the most important thing right now. So yeah, feel free to drop hi, because this is a completely community webinar. We only have the VMaker users here. And if you guys haven't joined our community on Facebook and Slack, please do join there as well. You know, that is where we have a lot of interesting conversations. People do share a lot of their use cases, like what Belinda did, about her own particular use case, how she uses VMaker to share reports and to get a lot of clients using VMaker. So that's a video which we will be uploading to our YouTube channel pretty soon. Wait for the same there as well. And if you guys have any particular use case which others can learn from, then yes, please do let us know, and we'll be happy to check that out as well. Right. So we have a question from Kevin. When is the Blur future going live? Okay, and we have a few more. Okay, Kevin, the Blur future, it is something which we are working on, and you can expect it by somewhere around Q3. We just have a lot of priority fixes to make at this point of time, which we are currently working on. Basically, it's just based on priority. People just share as, you know, their requisites, whatever they have. And we try to understand the priority based on the number of repeats we get for that particular feature. So based on that, we decide, and you can expect the Blur feature, you know, to be live either by end of Q2 or early Q3. That is exactly when I can tell you that it will be live. Thanks, Javan. Thanks for adding the links to join our channels as well. And we have one more. Maria says, great stuff. I look forward to checking it out. Thank you for all the materials. Hey, thanks, Maria. Pleasure as ours. I hope I answered some of your questions as well. And yep, at any point, if you guys have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Josh will always be there to help you out. Right. Let me just give me another 2 minutes. Okay. So Anand has a question. Once I buy tier one, is it possible to add a new license at AppSumo? Yes. Yes, Anand, you can absolutely do that. So you can start with tier one and you can scale it up to tier five, which basically is the same set of features, but then for 150 users. So it starts with 3 users at tier one and scales up to 150 users at tier five. You can just check the link and you will get all the details there. And yeah, you just have to pay the difference amount if at all you're upgrading from tier one to tier five. You don't have to pay the complete amount. There is an option to upgrade within AppSumo. You can just use that and upgrade the same as well. Okay, Hunter from John Wicket. I've been using vMaker videos in my email and so far it has worked very well for me. Kudos you all. Oh, that is the best part. This is exactly what we are trying to hear. I'm just going to take a screenshot of this particular thing and then, save it for later. thanks John, we really hope to talk to you more, hear more about your particular use case as well. Who knows, you can be the next vMaker of the month, man. I'm really looking forward to you. Thanks again for the words as well. That's from John. So if you have any more questions, let me just give me another 30 seconds probably before we close it out. Okay, one more question from Keith. Possible to give annotation feature in free version? Not right now, Keith, but the annotation feature is probably one of the major addition to the paid plan as well, especially with the startup plan. So yes, at this point of time, I have to give you a no for the annotation feature. But then, you can always upgrade to the startup plan if you feel that is something that suits you. But if you feel like the tool is best for you and if you're planning to use it in the long run, then yes, I do suggest checking out the AppSumo offer, because honestly, it's a staggering deal and, it's not coming back ever again as well. So I'm pretty sure it'll be a worthwhile investment from your end as well, if you choose to use vMaker over a long period of time there. All right. We have a few people who have requested to join the Facebook community as well. Javan, I think that's open for you up next. Cool then. I think if you guys have any more questions about the upgrade or if you guys have any questions about the tool or the features, always feel free to reach us through the in-app chat support. We have a 24/7 chat support live and we are pretty sure we would be able to cover any issues you have ASAP. If not, at least give you the right timeline if it is going to be a huge fix then. With that saying, you guys are the fundamental users and we definitely hope you upgrade to the paid plan because we don't want you to miss out on a pretty killer deal there. And if you have any questions or probably any thoughts in your mind which you want to get clarified before doing that, we're always open to answer your questions. You can reach us through the community or you can also reach us through the in-app chat support as well. We'll be happy to answer there. Okay, final questions from Harshita. Can I ask a question of Honeymaker? Not exactly, Harshita. I'm sorry, I don't think I would be the right person to answer that because we are a separate team for vMaker. Anything on vMaker, pretty sure I can cover it up for you. Anything on Animaker, I think you need to reach out through the chat support within the Animaker dashboard. And I'm pretty sure they'll be happy to, help you there as well. So yes, with those, thank you guys. Thanks a lot for joining here today. And we hope to see you guys once again soon in our next webinar there as well. And meanwhile, like I said, if you guys have any questions, please do drop us and please don't miss out on this killer deal once again. Until then, thanks and cheers. Thank you. Thank you, Javan, as well.
Thank you.
Thanks, Javan, for being my co-host. And yep, see you guys again in the next webinar. Until then, cheers. Bye-bye.